Hello students again. Today we will continue to talk about the elements of design. And now I will discuss shape. Okay, so shape is also, it's the third element of design. What is shape? A shape is an area that is enclosed by a line, okay? So these are lines, okay? But when they enclose something, it makes it look like a two-dimensional shape. So if I have this kind of line, the enclosed area inside makes it look like a circle, okay? So an area that is enclosed by a line creates shape. Now, the three basic shapes, the very, very basic shapes, are the square, the circle, and the triangle. So any other shape that you see, which is, can be complicated, very complicated shapes, okay? They are made from these three basic shapes. Any shape, any design you see in this world, okay, that has shapes, the starting point is these three shapes. Now, I can transform these shapes, combine them and transform them in a way to create other shapes. But initially, these are the three basic shapes, okay? And often, when you design something, you do not start with the complicated shapes. You draw, if you're drawing and sketching, you draw and sketch the design using the basic, more simplified shapes, okay? And then you start adding more details, changing the shape, okay, to get to your final design. Now, here we see some two-dimensional shapes. These are the basics one, as I said. We can see other ones here as well, and they have their own names. Trapezium, pentagon, for example, if it has five angles, all of these, the more angles you have, you see, every time you add more angles, it gets closer and closer to a circle, you know? And each of these shapes have their names, okay? They are geometrical shapes, geometrical shapes. So the circle, the oval, you know, all of these shapes are known. They have their own names. But look at these shapes, for example. These are blended shapes, meaning they are made from the basic shapes. They are made from these, okay? And possibly combining some of the other geometric shapes, and they are blended together, okay? And look at the result. You create so many different new shapes by blending shapes, blending the basic shapes together. Look at these. These are organic, freeform, biomorphic shapes. These words here describe these shapes, okay? Biomorphic and organic. Now, all natural things, like if you look at animals, humans, plants, most of the shapes that you notice are from these types. Biomorphic, organic, freeform, okay? And they have some, but if you look carefully, for example, in nature, at a flower, look carefully. You will see this kind of shapes most of the time. But if you look carefully, you will see very organized order of geometric shapes. The base of these, okay? Is a very organized geometric base. I'm talking about plants, I'm talking about humans, animals, everything in the natural world. Observe it, you will see how geometric shapes are used, but in an organic, biomorphic way. So it's rarely to see, for example, extremely, you know, like rigid straight lines, but you will find the base of it is geometry, okay? So there are many, many different types of shapes. There are basic shapes and a combination of the basic shapes which create more difficult, a lot of different types of shapes. And this is also a very strong element of design that you can use to create compositions and to create certain feelings, certain effects, to communicate certain things, okay? So, of course, shapes can also convey mood, feelings, okay? So the way you use the shape can make the viewer, the audience, feel certain in a certain way. Like all the other elements of design, like line, okay, for example. Now, there are three classes of shape, major three classes. The geometric ones, the natural, and the abstract. Now, the geometric, which is kind of mechanical shapes, they have pure form, okay? They have a very pure kind of form. The natural are more organic and irregular. It's not like the geometric are regular shapes, okay? The natural are a little bit irregular, so it's not like a perfect shape. It can indicate that it came from this shape, but it's not perfect. Here, for example, an example. This is a geometric shape. And if you look at it, it's actually made of two shapes. Look, the triangle and the rectangle, okay? Put together, but in a rigid, a geometric way, okay? Here, for example, the next one, we can see an organic shape. Organic, you know, it's more natural, more, the lines are, you know, used are more softer. So the shape created, this is organic, this is geometric, okay? This is abstract. Now, what is representational? Look, representational and abstract. What's the difference between them? Representational is when you look at a shape, and you recognize what it is, okay? Now, when we look at this, now we know what this is, a person sitting on a wheelchair, but it is drawn, the shape combination is made abstract, so it is not close to the real look. Like, for example, if I want to draw a person on a wheelchair in a representational way, I will put a lot more detail. I will make it look much more closer to reality. So for example, a real person does not look like this. Your head is not a circle, okay? The body does not look like this. The hands do not look like this. So if I want to draw this person in a representational way, I will make it more realistic. Looking realistic, okay, so closer to the natural look, but and also the wheelchair, you know. Sorry, okay, so the wheelchair. Look here, we have just a part of a circle that indicates the wheelchair, and it's enough. But if I want to draw it in a representational way, I would put a lot more detail. So this is an abstract version of basically a human sitting on a wheelchair. This is abstract. You must remember these two words, representational and abstract. It is used all the time in design. And when you talk about designs, you need always, the design is either representational or abstract or something in between. And you need to know these words when you talk about the design, your designs, okay? and you need to understand them. So if I tell you in a project, please do not use representational techniques, use abstract way, you need to understand what I mean, okay? So this is an abstract version of a person sitting on a wheelchair, and it's designed this way for a specific reason, okay? You cannot always design and draw in a representational way. Sometimes you need to abstract ideas, abstract meaning simplify, okay? The representational, often it's with a lot more detail, a lot more complication. Sometimes in design, we need to simplify it, the shapes, and make it abstract, the end result, for specific reasons. It could be that I'm designing a logo for a company, or for example, a sign. This is a sign, okay? So depending on what I am designing, sometimes representational is okay to use, sometimes abstract is okay to be used and must be used actually. Now, shapes and meanings. In general, when you have shapes that employ curves and circles, they give us a more soft feeling, a more peaceful, softer, feminine, you know, like these kind of feelings. Look at this, for example, and compare with this. Okay, what kind of feeling does it give you when you look at this and when you look at this? Rectangular, it gives us a feeling of trust, of order. Okay, security, it's a little bit more masculine, it's solid, it's reliable, predictable. These kind of words fit the rectangular shape in general. So when you see a rectangle, for example, a cube or a rectangular shape, this is what it makes you in general feel. Now, of course, again, we have a lot of, it can become more complicated than this, because you can combine shapes together, you know, and this can change the end feeling. But I'm talking about only one shape, for example, or a simple kind of compositions like this one. Okay, so rectangular shapes makes us feel things, certain things. Curves and circles makes us feel other things. Now, triangles are generally shapes that makes us feel more like energetic. Now, it depends on how the triangle is drawn. Like if you draw a triangle like this, with the pointed part here, it gives us a feeling of more stability, okay? And it can draw our eyes towards the tip. Now, if I draw a triangle with all the, like 60, 60, 60, it's different, 60, 60 degree, I mean. It's different than if I draw a long triangle with a pointy tip. Then our eyes are kind of drawn towards this tip much more than if it's just a regular unilateral, you know, triangle with all the sides the same and the angles the same. So if the tip points up, it is also a certain type of feeling. But what if I draw the triangle like this, with the tip pointing downwards? This will give us a more of a feeling of instability. Because the tip is kind of down, and unconsciously we feel that there must be a surface here down. So if the triangle stands on the tip, it's a little bit unsettling. It's like the balance, okay? It's unstable in a way. So what feeling does it give you? It depends on also how you draw it and how you modify it, okay? The shape itself. Like for example, a rectangle, if I draw it, okay, if I draw a cube, it's different than if I draw a rectangle or a longer rectangle, okay? Or if I draw this rectangle tilted or standing like this or vertical. So all of these things matter, okay? Shapes can also be used to create a texture and define space and separate and emphasize and produce mood. The mood already we discussed, but we can use shapes, like I can use specific type of shapes and maybe draw them really small. And together, the way I combine them together, I can create the effect of texture again, of a certain material texture, okay? They can also define space, okay? The space, we will talk about space. The space is another element of design. We will talk about it later. But after we discuss the space, you can go back and you will understand a little bit how the shape can define the space. It can separate and emphasize. Like, for example, I can use shapes to make the visually to separate something, separate it, okay? Or to emphasize. We will talk about this also later on more, but for example, I want this area to be very important. Like when the viewer looks at the design, to see this area first. So I can use shapes in a way to emphasize this area, this important, you know, part of my composition. So this is also things to think about and consider when using shapes in your designs. Here are some examples of shapes being used in designs. Here, for example, you can see this regular geometric kind of shapes. Look, they're actually all of them triangles, but the sizes, you know, the sizes from big, they become smaller and smaller and smaller towards the center. So when we look at it, it makes us feel something, okay? Something is drawing attention towards the center again, but it's very geometric, very regular, you know, like the straight lines you can see. Okay, they're kind of at an angle, all of them, but they're very geometric. All of them are triangles, all of them are clean shapes. It gives us a totally different feeling than if we look at this one, for example, which employs more organic, smooth shapes and in a totally different design. Compare this, for example, with this, or this one with this. All of them use shape, but in a totally different way. Look at this design. Look at this design, for example. Look at these shapes, how they are combined, how the sizes change. Now, here also another element of design was used, which is color, okay? But if we ignore this part, that color is used, we can also see them in a different way, because the color also influences us, the way we see the shapes. And we will discuss color later. Now focus only on the shape, on the shapes, okay? And try to understand what feelings do you get, or at least what's the difference between, for example, this feeling and this feeling, or this and this, or this and this. You need to find the vocabulary that expresses what is in your mind, what is it that you're feeling. You need to extract somehow this vocabulary. Look at these shapes, for example. Because they're in black and white, it also makes us kind of like as if they're separating the space in a way, defining the space, you know, because we don't have now color like here. We only have black and white, which is can be considered positive and negative space. As I said, we will discuss space later, but here we have only this or this, black or white, okay? And it gives us a totally different feeling. So, but focus on mainly on the shapes. Now look at these shapes. So we have squares, we have rectangles here, here we have circles. We have a combination, a blending of shapes. Here we have also blended shapes. Look at this final shape. Looks, you know, in a certain way, but it is made, it is based on the simple basic shapes that are combined now, okay? Here we have more shapes. Actually, actual designs, okay? Here we have signs. here we have also, sorry, these are logos. And these are signs, okay? Logos and signs. Shapes are used all the time in designing logos and signs. So every company has a logo, even designers, like you as a designer, you should design your own logo, okay? And logos are made out of a combination of shapes in an abstract way, in a simplified abstract way. Now, there are certain reasons why logos and signs are done in an abstract way, not representational. So they are simplified. Like, for example, we already saw this. So a human does not look like this, but it is a simplified version for specific reasons, okay? You will learn that more when you in other classes, why logos, why signs should be designed in this way and not in a complex representational manner. It helps, for example, with quick understanding. So this can be an international way of communication between different people of different nations, of different cultures. Everybody can understand what this is. Maybe not everybody can understand the languages, but all the languages, but the sign, okay? Everybody can understand what this means, okay? So with logos, there is a little bit different reasons, okay? So you're putting an idea behind this, the design of this logo. You're putting an idea behind it and you try to design, but also in an abstract, simplified way. So that, again, for many different reasons, okay? Like, for example, if you're a company and you have to, like your logo, you want people to remember your logo. Now, if it's very complicated, it will be a little bit hard for people to remember the logo. But if it's something that is so simple, but so specifically designed in a way that sticks in your mind, you know, you will remember this company. And this is part of the success. Also, when you print, like, you know, headers and business cards, companies usually have, and they always put the logo on it. So the business card is so small, the header, the letter, you know, like, they also have the logo, but usually it's black and white. So you need to consider when you print this, after you print the logo in black and white, it has to be also very clear and understandable. If you print it on a small business card, again, it has to be clear. If it has too much details, too much thin lines, too much going on, if it's representational, no way it can work. No way, okay? Here, more, again, signs. These are most of all signs, yes. So they're telling you something. They are telling you. They are telling you, for example, something, but in a very clear and very specific way, okay? So what does this tell you? What does this sign tell you? What does this sign tell you? Every sign tells you a very clear message, a very clear message. And all of them are designed using shapes. We are talking about shape now, okay? All of them are designed using shapes and combination of shapes in an abstract way. Okay. So we talked about shape. Now we will discuss form. Now, what's the difference between shape and form? There is a difference. Forms, now shapes were two-dimensional objects, flat, two-dimensional, okay? The forms are 3D, three-dimensional shapes. A form is a three-dimensional shape. So it has length, it has height, it has width. Now look at these. These are forms. Now, these are shapes actually drawn on, because they are drawn on a paper. A paper is a 2D surface. When I draw a 3D form on a paper, it's still 2D. It's still a two-dimensional object, but it looks 3D. It looks 3D, okay? So these, when I look at them, they appear three-dimensional, okay? So they appear to look like forms, three-dimensional objects, three-dimensional shapes. Look here again, we have other forms. These are the, you know, some of the basic ones. We have other ones here as well. These are blended forms. So when we take the base, some of the basic forms, again, we have, well, one of the basic shapes was a circle. This is what a sphere. One of the basic shapes was square. This is cube, okay? The, one of the basic shapes was triangle, and this is a form, a 3D form. I forgot the name of this one. So we have again the basic shapes, but now in three dimensions, okay? Now, when we combine these, we create blended forms, okay? And the result is, as you can see, a lot of new forms. A lot of new forms. These are composite forms. So you take the shapes and you put them together and you create a composite. It is like a composition, okay? The words are the same, composition, composite. It's like the composition is what composed of many elements. Composed forms are composed of many forms of three-dimensional shapes together. And they create a composite forms. Again, for specific reasons, okay? Depends what you are designing and what you want to the audience to see. These are also composite forms. As you can see, each one is unique. And the possibilities are endless, endless. You can create endless composite forms. This here is a real three-dimensional form, a real one. This one is a drawing of a three-dimensional form. So I already discussed this. I can draw on a paper a form, something that looks a shape, that looks like a form, that looks 3D. This looks 3D, but it is a drawing. But this is a real three-dimensional form. It is a real object. These are biomorphic forms. Again, we can see a lot of curves, natural looking forms. So these are biomorphic, okay? It's closer to something in nature, but it's also morphic, it's morphing, changing, you know? So also these are based on the primary geometric shapes and forms, but they are changed, okay, into to look very, very organic. Now here, biomorphic forms. This is a drawing of a biomorphic form. This is a real three-dimensional biomorphic form. Look at this, okay? So this is an architectural piece. This is a drawing. Now, every design starts with the, well, it doesn't start, but at some point there are drawings involved. In every design, at some point there are drawings involved before they can transform into final, real, three-dimensional objects, okay? These are products, table, chair, you know, bookshelf, sofa. Okay, so these are products using form. Form is what again? A three-dimensional shapes. Here we can see real three-dimensional shapes, just like here. This is a real one, a photo of a real three-dimensional, form. These are also real ones. This is a real one. These also, these are forms, okay? And they serve specific purposes. So this is a bookshelf. And it looks kind of biomorphic, if you see. It's very organic. So this serves a purpose of holding books. This here is a table made out of three-dimensional form. or a combination of forms. Look at this part and look at this part. This again, it looks so curved and so organic, but each part was made starting, so before this became a curve, it was a straight line. Most of you already took introduction to 3D design last semester. So if you remember, before we draw a curve or a circle, what did we draw? Straight lines. We used to draw a square and then use specific techniques and then draw the circle inside. So before a form becomes with all these curves, it was straight lines, okay? It used to be straight lines in the drawings, I mean, when the designer is drawing the idea. Okay, so this is examples of products using real three-dimensional form. Now, this is enough for now. Next time we will discuss more elements of design. Thank you for watching.